What am I doing up here in a tree? You know what? That's actually a great question. Not doing that again. If you're anything like me, you walk past trees every day and don't pay any attention to them. Unless a tree is strutting its stuff during peak leaf season, I could care less about these little f***ers. Until now.
New York City just released an updated version of their citywide tree map.
The city made an incredibly detailed survey of every single tree on the streets and in the parks of New York City. There are nearly 650,000 of them, and they're all included on this map, including this Tilia Americana near my house, ID number 374-7295. This unassuming tree has a trunk diameter of 8 inches, it absorbs 642 gallons of stormwater per year, and reduces 322 tons of carbon dioxide emissions every single year. That's the same amount of CO2 emissions as 80 cars. How could I possibly know all this?
Well, all this information and more is on the all-new tree map, available 24 hours a day to anyone, for free.
It's an astonishing repository of info about the flora that is all around us, but which most of us probably never take a moment to think about. I had no idea that this tree that I've passed hundreds of times before is a Gymnocladus dioicus, also known as a Kentucky coffee tree. There's a dang coffee tree growing near my house. Although you should not try to brew their pods because apparently they're poisonous. Good thing I got all this info from the tree map. There are other features on the new tree map as well. For instance, you can create a list of your favorite trees, you can submit a service request to the city for trees that need attention, and you can share trees on social media. Hold on, I'm gonna tweet this tree out real quick. You can also register an account and record your tree care activities, including cleaning litter and waste, which you know I'm gonna be doing. It also tracks all your tree activity, which is so wholesome that it makes me wanna cry. How did the city possibly get all this information about every street tree in New York? Well, between 2015 and 2016, 2,300 volunteers roamed the streets of New York, spending over 12,000 hours carefully documenting every single tree. I've never really paid that much attention to trees before, but I've honestly become kind of obsessed with this map. I've been looking up trees everywhere with it. There are more than 130 different species of trees on New York City streets, and this map has somehow gotten me excited about them. Like this green ash tree that's on my street, or this chestnut oak by my office. Or what about all the American elm trees on Eastern Parkway? They were last pruned on March 11th, 2019, which is insane that I'm able to easily access that information. I could see how people would think that this is a waste of time or energy. I mean, who really cares that this London plane tree conserves 2,245 kilowatt hours every year? Well, I do now. Unusual civic projects that are this ambitious are amazing. They inspire and educate people and help everyday citizens feel more connected to nature, which in an urban environment like New York can be pretty difficult sometimes. They also give people a way to be invested in their neighborhoods. In the past, if I saw a tree that wasn't looking too hot, I would just be like, damn, that sucks. Or more likely, I wouldn't have even noticed. But now I can report it to the city and have it taken care of. I'm not outdoorsy whatsoever, but this map has gotten me looking up random trees and reading about them online. Who would have thought? Me, a tree guy. And the fact that the tree survey got 2,300 people to volunteer their time for this massive undertaking is astonishing. I think that cities need more projects like this. Projects that get people to look at their surroundings in a new way, to feel more connected to the city and neighborhoods that they live in, and to know to not try to brew these things into coffee. Don't forget to like and subscribe.